أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Welcome back, dear brothers, sisters, inshallah. In our episodes of giving thoughts about the verses of the Holy Quran, كلام الله سبحانه وتعالى, and mostly I depend on tafsir Nur al-Bayan, which is my tafsir, and also some of the tafsir like Sheikh Sha'rawi's tafsir and Sheikh Imam al-Tabari and different tafsir. Let's see deeply the meaning of كلام الله سبحانه وتعالى. We finish the episode number 16, and today we're going to start 1 hour inshallah together, episode number 17 in Surah Al-Baqarah. We're still in the verse 126 of Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty said, وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ رَبِّ اجْعَلْ هَذَا بَلَدًا آمِنًا وَارْزُقْ أَهْلَهُ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ مَنْ آمَنَ مِنْهُمْ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ قال ومن كفر فأمتعه قليلا ثم أضطره إلى عذاب النار وبئس المصير. Verse 126, سورة البقرة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that statement about Prophet Ibrahim عليه السلام. Prophet Ibrahim عليه السلام, Allah said, وَإِذْ قَالُ, وَإِذْ قَالُ means in Arabic, during that time when Ibrahim said. When Ibrahim said, because we see the word or the وَإِذْ with Bani Israel, during that time of Bani Israel. Sometimes people say, Allah, he made Bani Israel monkeys and pigs and whatever, swan. This is for certain people in certain time. That's why he said, وَإِذْ. The word wa'id in the Quran means in certain time, with certain people, in certain place, not all the time until the day of judgment. We understand that. Wa'id qal, remember when Ibrahim was asking alayhi salam, Allah is Lord. Wa'id qal, remember when Ibrahim said, Ibrahim, Sayyidina Ibrahim, he made dua. He made a dua. And he said, Rabbi ij'al hadha baladan amina. His dua was, O Allah, my Lord, Rabbi, make that city safe and secured. What is the city? Mecca. Rabbi ij'al hadha al-balad amina. Make it safe and secured until the day of judgment. Why he said that? Because if you look before to Mecca, it was what? When Sayyidina Ibrahim left Hajar and Ismail. بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَارَعٍ. It's just, it was a valley, desert. Usually desert, when you tell people, go, let's go to the desert, they say, no, it's a desert. Maybe some gangs there in the way, gonna kill us, I don't want to go there. Nobody's there, we have to go. And also there is no fruits. It's a desert, dirt, dust, rocks. We have to go there, you know? فَاللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى when Sayyidina Ibrahim said, رَبِّ اجْعَلْ هَذَا بلد الأمين. Oh Allah, save this city which is Mecca and make it secure. Not just that. He said, وارزق أهله من الثمرات and give its people fruits. ثمرات. Why ثمرات? ثمرات means fruits. I'm sorry, it does not mean just fruits. ثمرات here means رزق, livelihood, too many things. That's why you see Mecca, mashallah, how many people they're going Mecca just in Hajj. And during the year time. Umrah, this is a different issue. All the year. What about Hajj itself? More than 6 million people, they go Mecca for Hajj every year. These people, they have dollars, they have money. They deal with business. They buy a lot of stuff. They use the ticket, they go, cars, whatever. Food, restaurants. See, it's life there now. Life, it's money. It's money, it's a big money. For this is, these people at Mecca or in general in Saudi Arabia, they live because of the barakah in this na'im, because of the barakah of dua Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. وَرْزُقْ أَهْلَهُ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ. Give them. Just give them. And How that city will be safe if it is still desert and there is no livelihood, there is no rizq there, there is no thamarat there? Of course, the security, it's very important. And one of the means of the security, to have rizq, to have money. Imagine that, mashallah, we live in palaces, but we don't have food. What kind of benefit? Is there any security? People gonna kill each other to get food. There is no a safe place anymore. That's why to have thamarat, this is like a fuel of the security. The fuel of the security. That's why Sayyidina Ibrahim, he understood what he's saying. Yeah. Sayyidina Ali said, لو كان الفقر مولانا رجلا لقتلت. If that poverty a man, I will go and kill him. Sayyidina Ali said that. That's why if somebody poor, they are masakeen. These people sometimes they change their religion because of their poverty. Because of their poverty, they change their thoughts, their religion, their creed, their faith, and look to the south of Africa. Yes, these people, they go to their missionaries, and they go to the Muslim villages, very poor, they are masakeen, wahidu, la ilaha illallah. Subhanallah, they change everything. Give them money, food, that's it. Yalla, get out of your deen. So that's why Sayyidina Ibrahim, he understood that to complete and to perfect the ni'mah and the safety for these people at Mecca or whatever around, give them thamarat, fruits. Warzuq ahlahu min al-thamarat. Sayyidina Ibrahim, he said, warzuq ahlahu min al-thamarat man amana minhum billahi wal yawm al-akhir. What about the rest? What kind of dua this? He said, only those who believe in Allah, Allah's oneness, and the hereafter, give them fruits, rizq. What about the rest? Kill them. No, Sayyidina Ibrahim. Allah said, no. عطاي الربوبية غير عطاي الألوهية. عطاء, understand this. عطاي الربوبية, it is different completely from عطاي الألوهية. عطاي الألوهية, to believe in Allah as one God, like Muslims believe, the monotheism. عطاي الألوهية just only for the mu'min. But عطاي الربوبية as a Allah, as a Lord, as your Lord, as a Rabb, he said in the Quran, رب الناس, he's the Lord of the all mankind, the Muslim and the Kafir. يبقى عطاي الربوبية for everybody. The one who worship Allah and the one not. Because Allah is still رب الناس, right? But عطاي الألوهية just only for the mu'minin, and that will be in the Akhirah mostly. For the mu'minin, bismillah. But we have to understand this very important point. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one who gave us all, Muslim and non-Muslim, whatever. He gave us the life, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because he is our Rabb. He is the one who gave us all the rizq, because he is still our Rabb. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he never stopped his khair and his goodness even to non-Muslims. Did you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stealing the sun every morning? Just give heat and just show itself to just the mu'minin or the Muslimin. What about the rest? No, the sun for everybody. Because the sun, it's makhluq. Allah created the sun. And the sun followed the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the sun for everybody. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not ask the air what we breathe, just deal with the only Muslims and don't go to somebody else. Subhanallah. فعطاي الربوبية for everybody. Allah is still رب الناس. وعطاي الألوهية for only the مؤمنين. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ومن كفر, الآية, Allah said, قال ومن كفر, for those, I am their Rabb, even if they are not worshipping me. I will give them whatever they want. I am their Rabb still. And he said, but the one who disbelieve, I will give him little joy in his life. فَأُمَتِّعُهُ قَلِيلًا. That little joy, which is our nafs loves, التكرار التمتع, continuously enjoyment in this life, even if he's a disbeliever, I will give him what? Eat, enjoy. Drink and enjoy. الجنس also enjoy. جنس طعام شراب whatever متاع الدنيا. There are too many things. Enjoy man. Enjoy. متاع قليل. It's nothing compared to الآخرة. And متاع الدنيا قليل. This is what Allah said in the Holy Quran. The متاع of this dunya, the joy of this worldly life is nothing if you try to compare it to الآخرة. Even if you see that joy in too many different categories, I can say, you know, people they enjoy in too many different ways. Even that is still nothing comparing to الآخرة. I said that, I was making my khutbah at King Fahd Masjid today. I said that to the people, brothers, Rasulullah said that our life in this dunya between 60 and the 70 years, and the average, this is the average of the life of our life. If you try to compare it with al-akhirah, which is just the day of judgment, 50,000 years, في يوم كان مقدره 50,000 سنة. What about the rest of the days? مولانا شيخ محمد, one day in al-akhirah equal to what? 1,000 years here. See, if you try to count your life, say you're gonna live 70 years, huh? The average. If you try to count it with the day of judgment or the rest of the days, you're gonna see your life بالضبط 1 minute and a half and less. قال كم لبثتم في الأرض عدد سنين قالوا لبثنا يوما أو بعض يوم أو we stayed 1 day or less of a day. Huh? Part of a day. بعض يوم. فاسأل العادين قال الله said إن لبثتم إلا قليلا less than part of a day. Less than that. بعض يوم he said no إلا قليلا less than that too. لو كنتم تعلمون if you really know but you don't know. For that's why الدنيا whatever متاع or enjoyment in this dunya compare to الآخرة nothing big nothing. And the dunya, it's a big deceiver. Remember when Isa alayhi salam was going with the Israeli man for da'wah, and Isa gave him 2 pieces of bread. And the Israeli had one, and he said, I have 3 pieces of bread. 3 pieces, huh? Sayyidina Isa said, keep them all with you, and when we get hungry, let's sit down and eat. When they get hungry, and Sayyidina Isa asked him for the food, the bread, 3 pieces of bread, you have it. And the man said, I have just 2. He said, what is the third one? I give you 2 and you had 1. He said, I don't know. The man lied. He loves the dunya, subhanAllah, even for this. So I said, Isa Ba'ath tried to show him some miracles. They woke above the water and they said, by Allah, the one who showed you this miracle, who take the third one? He said, I did not take it. Ya ibn al-lazina. Tayyib. After that, Sayyidina Isa, he make like small piece of dirt like this, you know, small amount of dirt, he make it like 3, and they said be gold, and they became gold. Long story short, I'm trying to make it short for you. He said, this one, this amount for me, and this amount of gold for you, and this, the third amount of gold for the one who take the third piece of bread. So I'm the one who take it. Aywa, dunya, man. قال رأيت الناس قد ذهبوا إلى من عنده ذهب. ومن لا عنده ذهب فعنه الناس قد ذهبوا. رأيت الناس من فضة إلى من عنده فضة ومن لا عنده فضة فعنه الناس من فضة. رأيت الناس قد مالوا إلى من عنده مال ومن لا عنده مال فعنه الناس قد مالوا. People loves those who are rich, those who have money, even dogs. الله يرحمك الشيخ. Even dogs. You see the dog, سبحان الله, somebody rich and they always giving to the dog food. You see the dog with its tail like this playing with him. But if his there is no food, dog, he'll eat you. Why? Because he's miskin, Zahalati. You know? The point here is Sayyidina Isa, he lifted the man. Said, man, take all of them, enjoy. I leave. Don't come with me. He left. Made his da'wah. And that man, while he was sitting back, like us nowadays in this dunya, subhanAllah. Dunya mata' qaleel. I'm gonna do that, I'm gonna do this, I have this money, I'm gonna make that, I'm gonna buy this. Three thieves, they saw the gold and they saw the money in the way. They killed him. They finished him. And Two of them, they said to the third one, go get us food very fast. We'll take the gold, we'll run away. He went to get food. Shaitan playing in their minds. Two, they said, when he gonna come, we'll kill him. We'll take all of gold for both of us. And he's Shaitan also telling him, poison the food, I will take all the gold. And they did. When he came, they killed him. When they ate the food, they died. The gold is still in its place. Isa alayhi salam came and he looked at four of them dying and the gold, dunya still in its place and they died. The dogs of dunya. Dogs of dunya. They love dunya so much. And Sayyidina Isa said, هكذا الدنيا was steering. هكذا الدنيا تفعل بأهلها. This is what the dunya will do with its people. Gonna use them. يا دنيا من خدمك يا دنيا من خدمنا فاخدمي ومن خدمك فاستخدمي. Oh dunya, if somebody serve us, serve him. If somebody serve you, use him. فاستخدمي, use him. فلذلك رسول الله يسوع سيئة الدنيا مطية المؤمن. الدنيا like a female donkey of the mu'min. He riding that dunya to reach his goal. But if somebody there now, dunya riding his shoulder like a female donkey riding his shoulder. And he's walking in the street. مجنون. المجنون اهو. ابن الهبل اهو. والله العظيم. الهبل اهو. الخيب اهو. Yeah. Yeah. فذاتس واي وات ايفر قل متاع الدنيا قليل ومن كفر فامتعه قليلا. الله سيد ذات. I will give him his joy. Enjoy. Dunya is nothing يا جماعه. And they said what is his abad in the hereafter? What is his final abad? ثم اضطره. اضطره I will force him. He has no choice. اضطره. If you force somebody, you're اضطره. Again, he has no choice in the hereafter. You have no choice. You have a choice now. In the hereafter, there is no choice. لا اختيار في الآخرة. There is no choice for anybody in the hereafter. There is no choice in the hereafter for anybody. Even your tongue, which is, you're saying kufr and bad words with your organs, including your tongue, in the hereafter, your organs will witness against you. There is no choice. You're gonna tell this my tongue, this my tongue, will never say anything about me. No. It will be against you. Because your tongue has no choice. Your hand has no choice. You have no choice. That's why Allah said, ثم أطره. Yes, Allah will force that person to go to hellfire. Subhanallah. Ya jama'a, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that Surah An-Nur, verse 24, and he said also Surah Yasin. يوم تشهد عليهم ألسنتهم وأيديهم وأرجلهم بما كانوا يعملون. These kind of disbelievers, their tongues, hands, legs will witness against them about what they used to do during their lifetime. But in the hereafter, there is no choice for you or your body. Verse number 127, Allah Almighty said, وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَاعِيلُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ وَإِسْمَاعِيلُ فعل مرفوع بالضم. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَاعِيلُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Verse 127, حق صبري. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ جَاءَتْ فعل مضارع. فعل مضارع للاستحضار الفعل. Like, Allah said, يرفع فعل مضارع. مضارع means in the present time. That happened long time ago. Why Allah said, يرفع. Still يرفع. He said, no, just to present the picture before your eyes. As if he's doing it right now. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ. إِبْرَاهِيمُ. Remember when. وَإِذْ. Remember when. Ibrahim and Ismail, both of them, they were raising the foundations of the Kaaba, al-Bayt, in al-Bayt. Wa Ismail, who built up the Kaaba's foundation? Malaika. Huh? Malaika, 40 years after Adam came, or before Adam, I'm sorry, after 40 years after Allah created the heaven and the earth. Malaika, they put the foundation of the Kaaba. And after 40 years also, they put the foundation of al-Masjid al-Aqsa in Jerusalem. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدِ. Ibrahim and Ismail, the father and the son, they were raising the foundations of the Kaaba. Is that was easy or difficult? It's hard work. you know, to get the stone from somewhere, stones, and to make that mud and to stand. طبعاً ما في كانش في سآلة, something to carry you up and do. That's why he put the stone under his foot, Sayyidina Ibrahim, Maqam Ibrahim. They made that job while they were so happy. That's why they made dua to Allah. رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا يَا رَبْ, we are doing that for your sake. Accept from us. They were so happy when they used to do that. Nowadays, somebody's coming to pray Salah Jama'ah بِحَمُّ رَبِّنَا جَمِيلًا وَلَا تَمْنُنْ تَسْتَكْثِرِ, as if he's telling Allah, يَلَّا, I came to your masjid. Huh? They're going to go to Jannah because they pray Jama'ah today. Ya أخوي, أنت. And sometimes when he comes to the masjid, he feels like he's doing Allah a favor, you know? He's favoring Allah something because he's coming to the masjid. He's not happy even when he's doing this. There is no iman in his heart. When you come to Allah, come while you are happy. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encouraged us into many ayat in the Quran. When you make ibadah, make it while you're happy. Make it while you are telling Allah, Ya Rab, I love you because that I come to you. Ya Rab, I am doing that just only for your sake. Sayyidina Ibrahim did it. Namrud was forcing him to worship him. Sayyidina Ibrahim said, no, I worship one God. I submit myself to Allah. I'm going to throw you in the fire. He said, well, do whatever you want. And then Allah turned the fire cool on Ibrahim. When he saw the dream, after he was begging Allah for a son, a child, when he saw the dream, after 14 years, before even he got Isaac, he got the dream, go from Palestine to Mecca, why? To slaughter your only son. I will. Submission, we learn submission from Sayyidina Ibrahim. He submitted himself. When Allah said, go raise the foundations of the Kaaba, you and your son, we'll do it. Sayyidina Ibrahim during that time, he was not a young man. He was old, in 90s of his age. Ismail, he was already almost 96. Well, Ismail, no, above 92. Above 90s, because almost he was 95, 96 when he get Ismail, the child. Imagine Ismail, say, became 14 or 15 during that time. Above 100. Ismail carrying the stones and giving to his dad and raising the foundation of the Kaaba. They used to do that, the father and the son, well, they were so happy. ربنا تقبل منا, oh Allah, accept from us. إنك أنت السميع, you are the all-hearer. العليم, you are the all-knowing. العليم, you know what we are doing. This is what they used to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's this big difference, dear brother and sisters, when you make the takleef, while you are happy or not. Sometimes we are big line in the masjid. Two brothers, they are praying behind with each other, shoulder and shoulder. But Allah will accept from some one of them, another one not. Do you know why? Because of the intention, because of the niyyah. Are you coming to make takleef as a burden above your shoulder, load, or you're making takleef while you are Allah? So happy inside your heart. Ya Rab, I love you, that's why I come to you. And when you finish, cry to him and say, accept from me. تقبل مني, like what Sayyidina Ibrahim used to do. And بقول لك, we are favoring Allah even when we come to the masjid. Wallahi al-azim. Some of us even, we come to the masjid to make problem with the imam or the khadim al-masjid or with somebody else. We are fighting, we are shouting, we are saying bad words in the masjid. There is no way, subhanAllah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he likes you to appreciate that hidayah he gave it to you. To appreciate somebody else making favor to you, helping you. And wallahi alhamdulillah, I'm not talking about myself. I see that with my eyes. Today after I make the khutbah, 2,000 people today, King Fadi Masjid. People hugging me, Shaykh, Jazakallah khair. Thank you very much. We like what you said. That makes me happy, not to be proud of that, no. May Allah accept. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide me to say maybe one word that somebody can change his heart. You never know. A lady came today, wallahi al-azim. You know, I was going janazah to 1,000 ox. I've been late because of that lady. She kept me in the parking lot for like almost 25 minutes. And I have to be in the way to go to 1,000 ox for janazah. You know, subhanallah. That lady from Indonesia, who's above like 60s, coming and start crying. Sheikh, thank you, but you said something in the khutbah today, makes me cry. I said, what happened, sister? Listen, sister, to this. Listen, sisters, listen. And she said, my son, front of my eyes, he get the gun and he shot himself. And he said, I want to get rid of this life. Bismillah, Allahu Akbar. Her son said that. Bismillah. He mentioned the name of Allah. Bismillah. She did not say Allahu Akbar. She said, Bismillah. Boom. And she said, I was thinking, it's a toy in his hand. It was a gun, real gun. And she lost her son. And she regret. She was crying. I said, sister, take it easy. Please, I take her phone number. Sister, take it easy. She said, I've been working as a nurse all of my life here. Why I bring my son to this country? I said, no, this is his destiny. But don't say why I bring him to this country. Why did not raise him in the Islam? She said, yes, you're right. And she was started crying and tearing. Don't blame yourself in the end. This is his destiny. I was trying just to make it easy for her sister, make dua for him and whatever. She said, because I said in the khutbah, I was talking about somebody extreme and he killed himself or killing somebody else. This is not an Islam or satit al-Islam. And she said, my son executed himself. He killed himself in front of my eyes. Wallahi, it's not easy. And the lady's crying. She said, I'm going to sell my house. I'm going to go to my country. Why I'm here? And I told her sister, why you say that? It is not because you are here. We have 2,000 people. They've been praying Jum'ah with you today. Their children, they did not execute themselves. Why you blame it to the, in America, everything? We blame somebody else. Why? Blame yourself. Why did not raise your kids in Islam? These kids nowadays, they think they are very smart, and they are not. They are not. Maybe they have some information, yes. But in the yani, wisely, or the way of life, they misunderstand too many things. Their mind now in technology and the internet and all of this, and they think they know everything. They don't know nothing. Life, it's a big school and the long term. And day after day, they will learn. It is not just like this. That's why we learn from our parents. Our parents, they were for us like role model. We learn from them. We listen to our parents. We listen to our father and mother because they have more knowledge and experience more than us. And that's why we listen. When my dad talk, I listen. I cannot look at him like this. Huh? My mom talk, I listen. Okay, hadir, inshallah. And think, this is the way. Subhanallah. I'm telling you, Sayyidina Ibrahim and Sayyidina Ismail, as a father and son, both of them, they submitted themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When they build up, they raised the foundations of the Kaaba, they start talking to Allah, Ya Rab, we do that because we love you. We pray because we love you. We read the Quran because we love you. We are good Muslims because we love you. We submit our faces to you because we love you. And in the end, O Allah, taqabbal minna innaka anta as-sami' al-alim. O Allah, accept from us because you are the all-knower, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rabbana, he said, verse 128, Rabbana waj'alna, they continue making dua to Allah. Rabbana, our Lord, waj'alna, both of us, Ibrahim and Ismail, waj'alna, both the father and the son, muslimayni, two Muslims, make us two Muslims, for you, lak, to you, lak, to worship you alone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, help us to submit our faces, our hearts to you, to make us Muslims. Not just that, look to their kindness. Sayyidina, I told you, Sayyidina Ibrahim, I love him to death. Sayyidina Ibrahim, I love this prophet. Sayyidina Ibrahim was so nice, so much. He became old, above like 100. His son carrying the mud, the stones. He was standing above Maqam Ibrahim, that stone where is his footprint still until now at the Kaaba, the Bayt al-Haram. And to take the stone and to put it in its place when he was raising the foundation of the Kaaba. And he's making dua to Allah to accept from him and his son and to make him and his son two Muslims. Not just him and his son. And also they made dua for their offsprings. for their descendants, the descendants of Ismail and Ibrahim. وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِنَا ذُرِّيَّتِنَا from our descendants أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَة Muslim nation. We are the Muslim nation. وَأَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا After we build up the Kaaba, we finish, show us our manasik, how to make hajj, how to make tawaf. This is manasik al-hajj. وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا Accept from us and accept our repentance. Huh? Because Allah, the one who put the repentance for us and the one who guided us to it and he accepted from us. Imagine that if there is no tawbah, repentance in Islam, people will kill each other. I killed somebody before. Let me kill more. There is no, I'm going to hellfire anyway. People will think like this way. I was a thief. But because of that, again, there is no repentance. I'm telling you, if there is no repentance, I take the money and the properties of somebody before. I'm going to the hellfire. Let me make it more. Huh? See? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is putting us, for us, the tawbah, repentance, that's good for the society and for me and you individually. Why? If you make something bad during your lifetime, huh? Allah is opening the door for you. The door is still open. Ask for repentance. Ask for His forgiveness, He will accept it from you. And our scholar, they said, if Allah guides you to repent, make sure He will accept it from you. See? Take it like this way. If He guides me to ask for repentance, means He will accept it from me. Because He already guided me. Right? If somebody will be misguided and he doesn't want to repent, he's kharba. How Allah can accept it from him? وَأَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا Oh Allah, show us how to worship you. أَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا How to carry the takleef. Do you know the takleef? Whatever you commanded us to do. This is the takleef. The law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ They asked Allah for tawbah. And for them and their dhurriyyah. And the tawbah, as I said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if somebody repent, that makes Allah happy. The hadith, لَاللَّهُ أَفْرَحُ بِتَوْبَةِ عَبْدِهِ مِنْ أَحَدِكُمْ كَانَ فِي أَرْضٍ فَلَاهُ ومعه الزاد والرحيل على الدابة وضعوا منه في النهاية قاعد يدور ما لقاهمش قاعد في نص الصحراء يعيط رمى نفسه في حفرة وقال لك لحد ما اموت بدل ما الغربان تيجي تاكل ايه الجثة بتاعتي the meaning that man is going to the in the desert with his camel with his food and water in the middle of the desert and somehow he said let me take a nap and when he woke up he was looking for his ride with his food, he did not find his ride. Was looking right, left, up, down for his ride, camel, but he did not find the camel. And he said, let me dig a hole and put my body in it until I die, because he's in the middle of the day, where are you gonna go? There is no food, water, there is nothing. He will die, and he will bury myself when I'm alive. If I die, you know, the wild animal gonna eat my flesh. Let me bury myself. Suddenly, subhanAllah, while taban he was breathing, he was opening his eyes like this, about to die, he found his camel before him. He was holding the rope of the camel and said, Allahumma anta abdi wa ana rabbuk. Akhta'a min shiddat al-farah. Rasulullah said that. He was saying out of his happiness and he make mistake, Oh Allah, you are my servant, I am your Lord. Rasulullah said he did mistake because he was so happy. You know, he found his right. Allah will be happy more than that person if somebody repented to him. Allah loves the tawbah. That's why his name is the tawwab. He's the tawwab, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kullu ibn Adam, or bani Adam, khata. All the children of Adam mistaken. But the best amongst them, those who are repenting to Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Verse 129, Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah said, Continuous dua from Sayyidina Ibrahim and Sayyidina Ismail. Rabbana. I want you to remember that dua. They ask first to what? To accept from them their good deeds when they raise the foundation of the Kaaba. And then what? They ask Allah to make them both Muslims, to submit their faces to Allah. And then what? to accept their tawbah, to guide them to their manasik ibadah, to show them the ibadah. Look to this. And to also to make their followers and to bring a big nation, Muslims, to follow them. And these Muslims, they are the nations of Ismail. And he said, verse number 129, Rabbana aywa. I love this. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Look, Sayyidina Ibrahim, how was so kind. Me and you because of Sayyidina Ibrahim. How? I will tell you. Your Prophet Muhammad came because of the dua of Sayyidina Ibrahim. رَبَّنَا وَبَعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُو عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. When Allah do anything out of His wisdom and knowledge. Allah is not like us. When Allah makes something, because He knows, you don't know. Because of His wisdom, out of His wisdom, He make it. Ya Rab, my son died. Ya Rab, I lose my money. Ya Rab, people insulting me. Ya Rab, I'm bad. Ya Rab, I am sad. Do you think Allah make you like that? Sometimes you do it yourself. But you have to accept your destiny. Because Allah wise, He's Alim, He's Hakim. He's Alim, He's Hakim, not like us, Qasim Bai, name Hakim Khatrajan. We don't have knowledge and we think we have everything. Your name Hakim Khatrajan, doctor, you cannot give prescription. If you're not licensed and you study all of your life to be a doctor with license and you practice, I will not accept your prescription because your name Hakim Khatrajan. You're half Hakim, right? I cannot accept that fatwa from that Kharban Sheikh. He doesn't know nothing. You know? Yes. Name Hakim Khatrajan Qasim Bai. I learned it from Qasim Bai. See? Sayyidina Ibrahim, Sayyidina Ismail Rabbana, Alif al-Itneen, both of them. They still making dua. وَبَحَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ. Oh, our Lord sinned from amongst themselves. The Muslim Ummah, huh? My descendants, offspring. Rasul, who's the Rasul? Prophet Muhammad, alayhi salatu wassalam. Minhum, from amongst themselves. Rasul minhum. Sometimes you make dua and we are waiting outside the masjid. Ya Rab, I'm waiting, huh? Outside the masjid, yalla, I need. I've been asking you inside the masjid. You can't wait. You can't wait. You cannot force Allah to do whatever you want. Allah la taqa alayhi al-ashi al-jabriya. Allah is not majboor. You cannot make Allah majboor. You cannot force Allah to do something for you. Allah, the one who will ask you, you cannot ask Allah. La yus'alu amma yaf'al wa hum yus'alun. Yes, you understand this. Fasayyidina Ibrahim, before more than 4,000 years, he made that dua, and after 4,000 years or more or less, Allah accepted his dua and he sent the Prophet Muhammad. And you can't wait for a couple of days. Allah will give you whatever you want. Between the dua of Sayyidina Ibrahim and the answer of the dua from Allah, 4,000 years. Yes, he sent the Prophet Muhammad after 4,000 years to us. رَبَّنَا وَابْعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ. Why Rasul Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to us? First of all, he said, يَتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكْ, to recite for them or to them your verses of the Quran, آيَاتِكْ. And reciting the Quran, it is different completely from التلاوه, it is different completely from التعليم. Because he said, يتلو, after that, ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكم. Recitation or reciting the Quran is completely different from ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكم. Two jobs. The recitation of the Quran, number two, teaching them to teach them what the job of the prophet. الكتاب to teach them the Quran. والحكمة what is الحكمة? The Sunnah. The Sunnah. Why القرآن I explain it like that way. الكتاب it's the Quran and the Sunnah it's the حكمة it's not the wisdom. لا. But طبعا of course the Sunnah it's full of wisdom but the meaning it's Sunnah. Why? Look to this ayah number 34 سورة الأحزاب. واذكرنا الله سبحانه وتعالى was commanding the wives of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and أهل آل بيته واذكرنا ما يتلى في بيوتكن من آيات الله والحكمة ها واذكرنا means remember and mention that whatever Allah سبحانه وتعالى is telling you the recitation of the Quran in your houses means the mothers of the believers recite the Quran in your house واذكرنا ما يتلى عليكن the wives of the prophets and his daughters of course من آيات الله from the verses of Allah والحكمة والحكمة means the wisdom the sunnah of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم and when Allah سبحانه وتعالى said here ويزكيهم يبقى to recite the dua of Sayyidina Ibrahim to send from amongst them prophet Muhammad رسول His job is, صلى الله عليه وسلم, to recite the كلام الله, Quran, آيات الله, and to teach them the Quran teaching is different from recitation. To teach them its meaning, its rules, do and don't, too many things. It's because the Quran is the law of Allah, system of Allah. And to teach them, تعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة, the sunnah. What else, number three or four? ويزكيهم What is تزكية means? تزكية means purification. Purification means what? طهارة. ويزكيهم يطهرهم. More you recite the Quran, more you learn the Quran, more you learn Sunnah, then you will be purified. You will be purified. When you have very filthy clothes, and you put it in your washer machine and for 1 hour or 30 minutes and then you get it and you put it in the dryer what gonna happen oh good smell wow it was bad this quality is tazkiyah purification when you make your wudu when you take shower we're making wudu 5 times a day see how you're lucky Allah wants you to be clean He wants you to be clean, Almighty Allah. وَيُطَهِرْهُمْ And the tahara purification, it will take you to the good ways. طريق الخير. And your iman will be perfect iman. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Sayyidina Ibrahim said, because, Ya Allah, you're going to give us all of that out of your wisdom and ilm. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ Indeed, you are, O Allah, Almighty, Almighty Al-Aziz, Al-Hakim, you are the wise, nobody can defeat you. You are the wise. Whatever you do, out of your wisdom in this universe. Verse 130, Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَمْ ملة إبراهيم إلا من سفه نفسه ولقد اصطفيناه في الدنيا وإنه في الآخرة لمن الصالحين Look at this ayat. After Sayyidina Ibrahim, he made the foundation of the Kaaba, du'as and all of that. And he said, man, submit yourself to Allah. And Allah said, after all of these gifts from Allah to Ibrahim, his son, and his Muslim Ummah, nations, and Prophet Muhammad, and all of that, this is the millat of Ibrahim. This is the religion of Ibrahim, alayhi salam, to worship Allah alone, to submit your face, yourself, your heart to Allah alone. And Allah said, this is Ibrahim, the one who used to love at-takleef, not love, ashiq at-takleef. That's why Allah, when Allah talk about Ibrahim in the Quran, He said, وَإِبْرَاهِيمَ الَّذِي وَفَّى He did fulfill all the commands of Allah Azza wa Jalla since he was young until he dies. وَإِبْرَهِيمَ الَّذِي وَفَّى. Sayyidina Ibrahim عَشِقَ التَّكْلِيفِ. Whatever Allah is to command him, he did not say, why? He said, yes, more, Ya Rabb. Give me takleef of Islam and extra more, because I love any order from you. I love you, Ya Rabb. That's why Allah said, anybody hates the millah of Ibrahim, he's stupid, safih. And I will tell you what is the meaning of safih now in Arabic language. Subhanallah. Ibrahim alayhi salam, they throw him in the fire. He was patient. He get his son, put him in that valley, Kaaba, desert. He was patient. Go after 14 years, slaughter your son. He was patient. Takalif, well, he was happy. Ya bunayya inni ara fil manami anni adbahuk, fanzur madha tara. Subhanallah. Wa man yarghabu, anybody refused, reject the millah of Ibrahim, the religion of Ibrahim, the monotheism, tawheed, Islamic monotheism, to worship Allah, the oneness of Allah, he is safih and ignorant and stupid. Illa man safiha nafsa. The safih person, Allah described that safih, the one who rejected the millat of Ibrahim, the oneness of Allah, that safih, I can call him, he is very weak, ضعيف. What kind of weakness? He cannot differentiate between the good thing and the bad thing. If you give him mango and, excuse me, shit, he can eat the shit and he can leave the mango. Yes, he's safih, abid, ahbal. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, Surah An-Nisa, وَلَا تُؤْتُ السُّفَهَاءَ أَمْوَلَكُمْ أَيُّوَا الَّتِي جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ خِيَامًا. Don't give the safih your money. Do you know why? Because he's weak here. He cannot differentiate between the right and the wrong. What's going to benefit him and what's going to harm him? That's why we see in our law, even in the Islamic law, if somebody became يعني, Alzheimer and became old, you see too many kids, they can go on the court and this, our dad now, he became weak here, you know, he can destroy our money and wealth. And they بيعملوا حاجة اسمها حجر. يحجروا عليه. They handle all the everything, they give him food and drink, that's it. And of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, safih, the one he cannot know and differentiate between whatever benefits him and harms him. Sayyidina Ibrahim, طبعاً Imam al-Razi, in his tafsir, he said that sufaha means women. I disagree with him. He said, don't give your money to the women because they are safih, they can waste their money. Of course, I disagree with whatever he said. I disagree with that. I'm telling you. Because Sittina Khadija and Sittina, I know some women, they are wiser than men. And they have wisdom more than men, their husband. And they are managing their house and their life better than the husband. Maybe the husband is kharban, he's a gambler and he's alcoholic and he's destroying his money outside his wife better than 10 men. That's why I disagree with Imam al-Razi about that. Some women, they raise their kids better than any men. In Egypt history, my country, Shagarat al-Durr, she was the ruler of Egypt, Nefertiti. You know, these women, they were better than Egyptian men, all Egyptian women, men. And even if you look to my culture, I don't know your culture, but I know a lot about my culture. In Egypt, I consider Egyptian women better than Egyptian men. Do you know why? Because they are very responsible more than men. You see the man sitting in the coffee shop, making argila and playing domino, and his wife working 24/7. She has a job, she's cleaning. She's doing all, raising kids, and he's sitting in the coffee shop in Egypt. No, I'm not Egyptian anymore. Alhamdulillah. They're going to be mad at me. No, I'm Egyptian, but I don't have the same mentality they still have it there. I'm Egyptian, I love my country. But I'm telling you, I don't have the same mentality these people, they still have it there. We have to change. I was telling in the khutbah today one word, and I was thinking somebody gonna fight with me, special somebody from Palestine or something. I did not mean the Palestinian. Palestinian, they are doing a good job. But I'm talking about those who are asking Allah. I said that in the khutbah today. Those who are asking Allah to pray one salah in the Masjid al-Aqsa, in al-Quds, while the Masjid close to his house like this, and he's not praying Salat al-Jama'ah in the Masjid. Even maybe he's not praying at all. And I did not mean to insult. No, of course, the Masjid al-Aqsa is very important for, like, the Masjid al-Haram, exactly, for me. But why you are keeping raising, and this is the reality. I like to talk about reality. You know, our hearts is full of shayateen. We have many shayateen in our hearts nowadays. And we just like to insult somebody else. I don't like this. See, for that's why, brothers, safih, that person, he's weak and he don't know what to do, and he cannot know his benefits and whatever harming and not harming him. Sayyidina Ibrahim, Allah said, وَلَقَدْ اصْطَفَيْنَاهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ. الدُّنْيَا and the الْآخِرَةِ, in the sight of Allah, they are not equal. They are not the same. That's why Allah said the dunya and the akhirah in the Quran. Allah chosen Ibrahim في الدُّنْيَا to be a prophet, a leader, imam of his ummah. إني جاعلك للناس إماما قال ومن ذريتي قال لا ينال عهد الظالمين. أيوة, because he made the dua, and the law of Allah cannot be in the hand of the ظالمين. سيدنا إبراهيم, Allah made him as an imam, as a leader, and as a nation himself. إن إبراهيم كان أمة. Why? Because he had all good attributes of all good Muslims. That's why he was a nation himself. إن إبراهيم كان أمة, سبحان الله. For that's why Allah said he chosen him as a prophet and messenger and leader and the imam الدنيا وإنه في الآخرة لمن الصالحين. He will be in very high position in the hereafter, سيدنا إبراهيم عليه السلام. Why? Verse 131, last one with me today, will answer the question. Why? إذ قال له ربه أسلم. أسلم. قال أسلمت لرب العالمين. الله أكبر. This is the answer. We'll finish with this ayah today. All the universe created by Allah alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the control of the universe in the hand of Allah alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وحده عز وجل. سيدنا إبراهيم, when Allah commanded him to be a Muslim, to submit himself, full submissive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he was very submissive to Allah. Huh? سيدنا إبراهيم, he did not think twice. قال أسلمت. I will, that's it. And that will remind me about Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Everybody from the Sahaba, when Rasulullah used to call them to Islam, maybe let me, give me one day, give me 1 hour, let me think, let me see, maybe, maybe not. Like some Muslim nowadays. Too many excuses, too many excuses. But Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, he did not say that. Rasulullah invited him to Islam, I'm ready. Not at all, no thinking. That's it. Even when he came back from al-Mi'raj, they tried to make fitna between him and Rasulullah. Your friend Abu Bakr, listen, your friend said part of the night he went to Jerusalem, and then after that he went up to the seventh heaven and he came back while his bed still was warm. See, your friend is crazy, majnoon, insane. Look what he's saying. And Abu Bakr al-Siddiq said, did Muhammad say that? Abu Jahl said, yes, he said that. Abu Bakr said, I believe him. Allahu Akbar. I believe him. Man, I believe him in something further than that. What? The message itself. Being a prophet and a messenger. Brother Sabri, because he's sleeping, and I know he's recording me. I ask him, Abu Ahmed, please, I need like $100,000 from you. For just 1 month, I'm gonna give it back to you. And he said, just 100,000, Sheikh? I'll give you 200,000. I said, no, excuse me, just keep 100 for you. Just give me 100. I will accept it, no problem. When? Inshallah. After 1 month exactly, I knock his door. Jazakallahu khairan, this is your money back. I give him the 100,000, exactly what I told him. In this, the time, exactly I give him the money. After a while, I was in need to somebody also, to some money also, more. More? No, I want to, you know, Brother Sabri, do you know, I was doing something, but just I'm in need for $500. Can you give it to me? I will give it to you next week. He will give it to me or not?
Yes,
surely. Surely, right?
Yes.
Because I asked it already him for 100,000 and they give it to him. Do you think he will be in doubt or any doubt in his mind? I will take this $500? Of course not. This is exactly what happened between Rasulullah and Abu Bakr. The same thing I was telling you right now. I believe in something further than the, more than the, what the message. Message of Allah as a messenger. فَسَيِّدْنَا إِبْرَهِيمُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, Aslim, be a Muslim. Submit yourself to Allah. Sayyidina Ibrahim did not think twice. He said, أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَلِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَوْلُ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ When you say a Muslim means you trust Allah. Depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because sometimes nowadays I see too many Muslims they depend on somebody rich, has money. Yeah, maybe he's rich today. Tomorrow he will be poor like you. And he's going to beg you for money. Because I depend on somebody strong. Yeah, maybe he's strong today. Tomorrow he will be sick. Somebody still alive exists. Maybe he will die tomorrow. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never be poor. Will never die. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is self-sufficient and he is the one He controlled everything and he is the one who created this universe. Depend on Allah Azza wa Jal. That's why Sayyidina Ibrahim said, I submitted my face to Allah, the Lord of Al-Alameen, mankind. Lillahi Rabbil Alameen. If you will not do that, you take away other than the way of Allah, as a good Muslim, you are safih. Do you know what's the meaning of safih? I just explained it now. Somebody weak here, who don't know what is the benefit and what is the harm, who don't know. Inshallah, we'll continue next week. I stopped verse 131. And not just Ibrahim and Ismail, they submitted. وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَهِيمُ بَنِيهُ وَيَعْقُوبُ يَا بَنِيَّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمِينَ Ibrahim, he was and direct father to the all Anbiya. He was the oldest father. But Jacob here, was Sabiha Ibrahim Bani Ibrahim, he gave the will, the wasiyya. And the wasiyya in Islam means what? To say something good for the last of your time to benefit somebody. This is called wasiyya, the will. You cannot deceive your children before your death. Did you see anybody loves his children? While he's dying, he's deceiving them? No. That's why the wasiyah, the trust is very important. And Sayyidina Ibrahim, he advised, he gave the admonition, the wasiyah, the will to his children. Die. Don't die except while you are in the condition of Islam. Be a Muslim. And Jacob too, why Jacob? Why Allah jumped? I did not jump it. Why Allah did not mention Isaac? Isaac, the son of Ibrahim, he said was Jacob. Why Yaqub? Do you know why? Because Jacob, he was the direct father of the Jews, Yahud. The 11 sons, and Sayyidina Joseph, Yusuf, they are the children of Jacob. And Jacob, that's why the Quran said, Ya Bani Israel. Who's Israel? Prophet Jacob. Ya Bani Israel. Oh, children of Jacob, the direct father to the Jews. Huh. We'll continue this inshallah next week. Jazakum Allah khairan. Please go to my channel, YouTube channel, Noor N-O-O-R Al-Bayan A-L space B-A-Y-A-N Noor Al-Bayan and share this tafsir. We are in the episode number 17 hours now. We're still in the verse 131, Surah Al-Baqarah. Fa-inshallah, share this khair to others in your Facebook, in your WhatsApp, in your whatever you have. Just share the link, inshallah, and let everybody subscribe this, inshallah, to get the benefit. Ad-dallu ala al-khayri kafa'il. Ameen. Jazakum khair. Assalamu alaikum.